For the enemy has persecuted my soul, he has crushed my life to the ground, he has made me dwell in darkness like those who have been long dead, and my spirit is overwhelmed within me. My heart within me is distressed. I remember the days of old, I meditated on your works. I pondered on the works of your hands, I spread out my hands to you. My soul longs to you like a thirsty land. Hear me quickly, O Lord, my spirit fails. Do not turn your face away from me, lest I be like those who go down to the pit. Cause me to hear your mercy in the morning, for in you I have put my trust. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way in which I should walk, for I lift up my soul to you. Rescue me, Lord, from my enemies. To you I have fled for refuge. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. Your good spirit shall lead me in the land of righteousness. For your name's sake, O Lord, you shall quicken me. In your righteousness, you shall bring my soul out of trouble. In your mercy, you shall utterly destroy my enemies. And you shall destroy all those who oppose my soul, for I am your God.
God is the Lord who has revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Be thanks
to the Lord who calls on his holy name. Deus qui Dios, que et fan et in me, so et for manos, and on all my people.
Then they shall offer both on your altar.
Most holy Theotokos, with many temptations surrounding me, searching for salvation, I have hastened unto you, O Mother of the Word and ever Virgin, from all distresses and dangers deliver me. and to you we sing a hymn of praise, knowing you to be the Mother of God.
Alla fossa di la buche sos, non so dirlo.
seed of Mary.
Received from you.
now. You are the peace of those in conflict, the calm of those in turmoil. God, save your people and bless your inheritance. Look upon your world with mercy and compassion. Raise the Orthodox Christians to glory and shower us with your abundant mercy. In the intercession of the most pure Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, by the power of the precious and life-giving cross, the protection of the honorable body and the powers of heaven, the supplications of the honorable glorious prophet and forerunner John the Baptist, of the holy, glorious, and praiseworthy apostles of our fathers among the saints, the great hierarchs and ecumenical teachers, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasios and Cyril, John the Merciful, Patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas, Bishop of Myra, and Lysias, Vera, Bishop of Emetus, the commemoration of whose miracle we can keep today, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Victorious, Demetrius the Merciful, Theodore the Recruit, Theodore the Commander, of the holy, higher martyrs, of Alamos and Ephanius, of the holy, glorious, and triumphant martyrs of the venerable, godly, ascetic fathers, of the holy, righteous ancestors of God, and Joachim and Anna, of the holy Evus, the deacon, of our righteous father, Ephraimus, the patriarch of Constantinople, of Blaine, the bishop of Butte, whose memory we commemorate today, and of all the saints, beseech you, O merciful Lord, hear us sinners who pray to you and have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The so that I may praise you, O Lady in God's favor.
Thank you.
Gratia megalia su Theou imon. Thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever to the ages of ages.
Amen.
You were transfigured on the mountain, O Christ God, showing to your disciples your glory as much as they could bear. Shine upon us also, sinners, with your light everlasting, through the intercessions of the Theotokos, O giver of life, glory to you. Your martyr, O Lord, in his courageous contest for you, received as the prize the crown of incorruption, life from you are immortal God, for since he possessed your strength, he cast down the tyrants and wholly destroyed the demons, strengthless presumption. O Christ, our God, has prayer to save our souls, since you are merciful. Look down forever to the ages of ages. Amen. The mystery hidden from eternity and unknown unto the angels is made manifest through you, O Theotokos, to those on earth. God became incarnate in an unmingled union, and for our sake has submitted willingly to the cross, whereby he has raised up the first fashioned man, and has saved our souls from death. Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. We pray for our Archbishop and Father, Sophus, and all the clergy and the laity in Christ.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. We pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, forgiveness, and remission of the sins of the servants of God, all pious and Orthodox Christians, those who reside and visit in this community and city, members, council members, contributors, beloved host members, and benefactors of this holy church.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the service of God whose names have been commemorated throughout this Paraclesis service, for those that we prayerfully call to mind at this time, and for those here present who await your great and rich mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the safekeeping of this holy holy church, and this city and all of all cities and towns, from pestilence, famine, earthquake, flood, fire, and the sword, especially the fires in Greece and California, from invasion of enemies, civil war, and unforeseen death, for his mercy to be that he will be kind to entreat as our good God, who loves all people, that he may turn away and scatter all wrath and disease that was against us, and deliver us from his impending justified chastisement, and have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
And we pray that the Lord God will hear the voices of the petitions of us sinners, and have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Hear us, O God, our Savior, that all the ends of the earth and of those far off upon the sea, and show compassion to us, O Master, our many sins, and have mercy upon us. For a merciful and loving God, our unity, we give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to you, O God, and glory to you.
He appeared on the earth one time, and we commemorate him on
November 8th, that's his feast day, November 8th for St. Michael, but we'll commemorate him on September 6th because he appeared on the earth one time in a mirror. And it had such an effect on the people of that area that it became not only a feast of commemoration for that area with regards to Archangel Michael, but it became almost a universal feast for the entire church with regards to that. Yeah, that's completely, you're not listening. So, when we commemorate today, we commemorate St. Ev, who's the archdeacon, who was a martyr of the church. We commemorate St. Nephon, who was patriarch of Constantinople. We commemorate that St. Blaine, which I don't know a whole lot about, today, but we commemorate St. Spiro. Now, if you know anything about St. Spiro, his commemoration is done, when is his main celebration? Do we know when his main celebration is, St. Spiro? December 12th. His commemoration of St. Spiro is December 12th. He is remembered for being at the First Ecumenical Council. They were asking about Jesus and God as Trinity. God is Trinity. And no one believed that God could be three as well as one. And so St. Spiro got up and took a brick in the middle of the council. And he took this brick and he said, look, this brick is one brick. But it's made up of three elements. But it's still one brick. It's made up of earth, fire, and water. And when he said it's made up of earth, fire, and water, the brick in his hand split. In the middle of the council, split into three parts, earth, fire, and water. So that he could explain the Trinity. One brick, what you see is one brick, but it's made up of three elements, earth, fire, and water. And so he said, look, the mystery of the Trinity is very simple. No one would ever say this isn't one brick. No one would ever say that this is three things. It's one thing. But you can't make this one thing without all three. And so he explained it in that regard. And so this miracle was remembered. But today is not the commemoration of that miracle. Today is the commemoration of a war that took place in Kekina, in Greece, a place where St. Spiridon is commemorated because of his body and his relatives that are in that region of Corfu and Kekina. That's all that kind of place where he was. And his body, actually, in that area, he's like St. Dionysius that we hear about in Zacchaeus. He's also in Corinth. Every once in a while, he'll be walking around. Even though he died centuries ago, he'll be walking around. St. Spiridon also has the pantofles, the slippers that wear out. Even though he is dead, she has slippers of St. Dionysius, not St. Spiridon. Okay? And so St. Spiridon is another saint from a different area that also has the same kind of commemoration. His body isn't corrupt. He has slippers that wear out. And people see him walking around once in a while. Well, about 300 years ago, 1716, I believe it was, 302 years ago, on this day, there was a huge war from a group of people called Muslims. And they were the Muslim Turks, and they wanted to take over this area of Kekina. And they were doing it. They were being successful in war. And they were having this conquest because those were people that needed to have conquest and war and fight and be angry with other people. And they weren't happy unless they were taking over and forcing themselves upon others. You know, they didn't give people a choice. It was a war, it was a conquest, it was all about politics and things like this. And so, and by the way, nothing's changed. So that still exists, even to this day, thank God, not in this country yet. So, but, you know, thank God. Nevertheless, this existed in that area. And the people there were nervous because, you know, this is their lives, this is their area, this is their city. And they fought and they fought and they fought and they weren't winning. And they tried as much as they possibly could to overtake the Turkish Muslims, but to no avail. So they had no other recourse, they had no other opportunity. They're in Kakhetia, they called upon their saint. Because in that region, Saint Spiro is like their saint, it's their, you know, person, the person that they would call upon. And they called upon him. This happened. This is a real story that happened 302 years ago. And when they called upon him, all of a sudden they started winning the war. They started to fight lightning, brilliant. And in that one region in Kakhetia, they overtook the Muslims. Even though they were outnumbered, they had already been losing, they couldn't fight, they couldn't do whatever. As soon as they called out the Saint Spirit, they started winning. And they started leaving their land free. Well, the Turkish Muslims weren't going to be outdone, so they went to the surrounding areas just outside of Kakhetia, and they started ransacking those villages. And they started overtaking their towns. And in one of those places, Saint Spiro himself appeared with a huge sword, larger than life. He appeared larger than life, with a huge sword and a host of angels. And he struck the Muslim Turkish armies with such a fear that they ran and fled. They dropped their weapons and fled. Now the people in those areas, they didn't know what was going on. They just knew that they were being ransacked, and you know, the people from Kakhetia heard, okay, yeah, we were victorious, but we hear that they're ransacking these other places. Pretty soon they're going to come right back in and they're going to attack us again. But when they went out to observe what was going on, what they found was a bunch of Turkish armor, a bunch of Turkish weapons, a bunch of Turkish things all laying on the ground with absolutely nobody to claim. And they were astonished. They didn't know what happened. And then they were told by individuals who were able to have witnessed some things. And then they praised Saint Spirit. And then they made a little procession. And in that area, it became a very huge feast, 300 years, that they've been celebrating this on this day. The fact that Saint Spirit helped preserve their freedom in that area. Not to a freedom, but their religious freedom. Because if you become under this Muslim rule, you're not allowed to be free to be a Christian. You're not free to be a Christian. So thank God that we've been preserved from that. Our ancestors were not. We've been preserved from that, thank God. So today we remember the Saint Spirit and how he helped keep Christ freely worshiped in those areas. And we implore, we ask that Saint Spirit continue to keep our places free so that we never have to worry about what's going to happen when we try to go to church. When we try to praise God next time. When we try to worship God next time. I don't think it will come, at least not, hopefully not during my lifetime, but we can never forget that in our past, these things did happen, and that God did deliver us eventually from those oppressors. Not all the time, but eventually did relieve us, not in all areas, even in some places around the world. So, we're going to come venerate the icons, and then we have her to be blessed with as we finish, and then we go back to the pews while we share. Let this one out. So she can go. Oh, you apostles from afar off, ye gather my body in bearing. I have you as mediator before God, who loves mankind. May he not question my action before the host of the angels. I ask of you, O Virgin, hasten now quickly to my aid.
You are the
The prayers of our Lady for Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
The Holy Trinity, bless, protect, and keep all of you, and may the blessings of our Lady, the Veiled Opus, and the Virgin Mary be with you, and Saint Spirit on this day be with you as you travel safely back to your homes. I got the warning on my phone that there was a flash flood this morning, so please be careful. But we just prayed for no floods. That was one of the things that we prayed for no floods. So may the Lord preserve us, and may he preserve not only us here, but in our homes as well. So, please be careful when you put your books away, and we will see you on Monday, well, Sunday for sure. See you on Monday. For Sunday for church, and then Monday also for Paráclisis. On Tuesday, we are going to be decorating the Pubuclio in the morning for the Vespers of the evening. Okay? Wonderful. God bless you.